Well, new at 5, an incident between a Bixby police officer and a 12-year-old with autism is prompting a Broken Arrow woman to take action. The officer is pursuing charges of assault and battery against an officer and resisting arrest after an altercation outside a Bixby school last month. As 2 News reporter Sierra Pizarro learned, the incident has prompted an autistic woman from Broken Arrow to begin a statewide effort to give first responders autism training.
Slow down, be patient, and don't touch me unless necessary.
This is Katie Lord. She's on the autism spectrum.
Just because we are waving our hands around does not mean we are threatening or violent.
For a month now, she's collected feedback from individuals dealing with autism. Her question is, if you could tell an emergency personnel anything to help them understand the disorder, what would it be?
No loud noises, please don't yell at me, please no sirens or lights or any of that.
200 responses later, and she's now on her way to creating a less plan, which she'll soon present to local departments.
I've gotten a lot of responses of, yeah, we do have some in training, but please come back.
And she will, because she doesn't want a misunderstanding to go wrong. Lord heard about a recent altercation between a 12-year-old autistic student and a Bixby police officer. It ended with the student being arrested.
If she, quote unquote, attacked the officer, she probably did not realize or recognize that that's what she was doing. And that makes it really challenging for me to wrap my head around the fact that you can charge her with this.
Master Sergeant Corey Sutton has taught over 100 classes to more than 2,000 officers since 2011 about how to respond to autistic individuals.
They just don't comprehend the world like we, and by we I mean neurotypicals, do, and it can cause some really negative interactions with law enforcement.
Oklahoma currently mandates 2 hours of mental health training for every full-time certified peace officer.
Our officers typically go over and above the statewide mandated minimum training for mental health hours. In the past, our training has included autism and associated disorders.
Despite current efforts, advocates push for more.
I'm also trying to work on legislation to mandate this training for all law enforcement in the state of Oklahoma.
Sutton was unsuccessful in getting autism training mandated in the past, but he looks forward to working with Oklahoma legislators and advocates to get it pushed in the 2022 legislative session. In Broken Arrow, I'm Sierra Pizarro, 2 News.
Sierra, thank you. According to the Autism Society organization, approximately 1 in 5 young adults with autism will interact with a police officer before the age of 21. Bixby police say due to the student confidentiality, they can't share many details of this case, but they say school staff was with the student at the time of the incident, trying to keep the girl safe.